Okay, we will begin now for the preaching in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We was looking yesterday in Romans 10:13, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. What does this mean? In simple words, we can understand that whoever is asking prayers, they will go to heaven. So we started like this yesterday. So what we can understand is, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This scripture, we must try to understand very nicely, because sometimes people are taking a wrong meaning of this scripture. And then they depend on that wrong meaning, and they will complain that nothing will happen. So this is happening most of the times when people don't know to take the meaning. First of all, we simply read the Bible, and like a sentence, we just read it and forget it. So if we see nicely, that is why I'm going again and again, so that whoever is listening or watching this video, they must know what is in this scripture actually. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. But how we will know how to call upon the name of the Lord? Saving is later on, but first we must understand how we can pray or how we can praise the Lord so that we will go to heaven. This was the second thing. So first thing, we are in the earth now. So let's see what we can do on the earth with this scripture. Heaven is far for us. We are still young. God promised a long life for us. We are just not even half the way. So let's forget about heaven right now. We will see what we can do in the earth, because if we don't live as per the scripture on the earth, what will happen is we will die soon. We will not get a long life, because we will not live as per God's word. That will be the big problem for us. If in simple language, if you read this scripture, then you are into big problem, because you will read like this. See, understand. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This I have told many times, even in the church, Father is telling, even in the Bible it is there. Lord, Lord, whoever calls Lord, Lord, will not all will enter in heaven. So we can match this over here. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So this is opposite to that. This is saying whoever say the name, they will go to heaven. Things looks like this. But other scripture is saying, we touch this topic, but we will go in the other way today. It is looking like opposite when we see other scripture. So we started like this yesterday. So now we will go ahead. So who will teach us how to call the name in order to go to heaven at the end? Keep in mind, at the end, one day. Now we will talk about the earth. We are in this world. We was here for a long time. We did not do anything. We was like a vegetable, a thing, just growing up, just doing the what we called as the duties of the world. Even a plant is doing the duty. Plant also have to give fruit. We were also doing the duty, but not according to the word of God. According to the trees, plants, things, we were also like in the worldly way, we were doing the things. Our life was going in the worldly fashion. So who will teach us? We heard so much everywhere in our life, in our church, in our Legion Mary meeting, in our charismatic, in our so much we are listening, but still we are operating as per the world, not as per the word, as per the people, their thinkings, as per them, we are also flowing with them. So we are like in the flood. When the flood comes, it takes away everything what is there nearby. So with the world, we are also caught up in this flood. It is called a rat race. So we are running along with the world. We are thinking, if we go and follow as per the Bible, we will leave behind everything. Everybody will overtake us and go. Finally, we will not have anything to eat. We will not have good gadgets, good mobiles, good cars, good houses. We think like that because we think people are already ahead of us. In the worldly mind, we are thinking that. But actually, to look, we are losing day by day. We are putting a full effort, 100% effort we are putting. But still, we are losing on something or the other. Maybe money is building up in the bank. But we are losing our peace. We are losing our family. We are losing our children. They go out of hand. We are losing our grandparents and all. They are dying soon. Or our parents are dying soon. So much things we are losing in this rat race. But who will tell us what to do? World is only telling us, go with the world. Go with the flow. This is the dialogue. Go with the flow. So if we go with the flow, where we will land? We will land in the ocean if we go along with the flood. And that is the place for the devil. Depth of the ocean is kept for the devil. So where we will reach? See, the result is clear now. I don't have to tell that we will go to hell. So if you are going in this flood, you are sweeping away with the flood, you will go in the ocean. Ocean means hell. That is where devil is. Clearly written in the Bible, God is casting the devil out and throwing into the sea. Example, scripture, the mountain. The tree, another example is there. So this, God is saying this, all sickness, disease, poverty, joblessness, you remove and throw into the sea, means where? You destroy it and live a good life. Abundant life, peaceful life. So this is the example Holy Spirit put me about the flood. So I don't have to tell you now that you will go into hell. This is telling you, if you go along with the world, you are sweeping along with the world, and that is, ocean is the last where it can go, the flood. So be careful. Don't take it for granted. Open up your eyes. Start a new day from today. Forget about all the mess. I'm telling this, repeating this again and again, because this is the things we must do. Again and again, I have to put it into your ear. It have to go into your mind. You have to change your thinking. That is very important. If I tell only one day, you will listen it, you will forget it, then you will never hear it again. Then you want new topic by topic by topic, then same old. You are same in the old pit, only you are there. So be careful. I'm telling you this warning. I'm giving you warning. Wake up. It is too late. You may not get a second chance because the devil, you don't know. He is coming like a thief, like a robber. We don't expect a robber to come only when we become poor. We don't have anything in the house or we become bankrupt. No, devil comes when we have money, when we are happy. That time devil know somebody is telling that they have a lot of money and the devil is coming. So when you have a lot of bad things going on, the death will come, the destruction will come, sickness will come, worries will come, jobs will go, families, this, all the problems is only because of this. So I'm telling you this again and again, if we talk this 5 minutes every day also, it is not bad. It is very good. And new people who are getting this video, maybe they are getting only one video. they have not heard old videos, and nobody may send them the new videos. So I give my number. If you get this preaching, my number is, don't miss out. WhatsApp, everything is there. UK code 0044-7598-489-008. I am always available whole day UK time. I don't want anybody to get lost. When you get this preaching, 100% you can save your soul. You can save your life on the earth. Forget about going into heaven. Earth, you save your life. God promised long life, abundant life. God saying, my plans for you are to prosper. Not to harm you. But why we get this all problems? Why we will say like that? Why all problems when God is saying, I will not harm you. My plans are to prosper. Everything is for your good. All because of our thinking. We are thinking like others are thinking. If not, we are saying we are out of the race. We are not in the group. We are not as per their standard. There is a standard of dressing, style, hairstyle, shoes, everything, there is a style. So you have to go with the flow. That is the world teaching. So now, how you will come to know? You have gone for so many preachings, no doubt. But what happened? No changes. You came back. 1 week was good. 1 month was good. Then back to square one. Why? Because the preacher who was preaching you, he was not in the grace of God. That is very important. If you are listening to a preacher, first of all, the preacher has to be in the grace. Grace means what? You know when grace is coming. I told you several times, but I will tell in one line. When you get faith, and we Catholics already have faith. So we have faith. When faith is there, when we confess the faith with our mouth, and we are ready, we are saying like Mother Mary, I am your handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to your word. This is very important. If you ask me, what is the name of your ministry? I don't have any name, but I will say, this is my ministry name. I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to your word. When you say this, the doors are opening of grace. God's grace come into your life. Like Mother Mary was conceived when she said this word. Same thing is happening in our life. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. There is no doubt. So be careful, very careful what you are thinking and how you operate. I am telling you, you have faith you have. I am not telling you to build the faith. If preacher is telling you to build a faith, that he is telling for the non-Christians, non-Catholics, I can say. That is not for you. Keep in mind, whenever you hear any preacher telling you, build your faith, no, it is not for you. In the initial stage, like we are now, we are on the 22nd day today. 22nd day. 21st, 22nd, Mackley missed 3 days today. So 22nd day today, we are in 22nd day. So our next step has to be to activate this faith. When we say, I am the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to your word. When you tell this to God, that we are available, we are working for you. Not you have to leave your parents and go to Africa or go to Japan or go to Saudi Arabia. No, don't leave anybody. Only say this word. Mother Mary did not go anywhere. She did not go when she got pregnant. She did not go to heaven because she got pregnant with Jesus. No, she was there in her own house. So don't worry, wherever you are, you have to confess, you have to tell God, it is your will. God will not force you. God is asking you every time, because Jesus has told you, no need to ask God anymore. Jesus has told you at the table, Last Supper, go and do this in remembrance of me, means what? Go and tell everything I did in my life. Not only eating the bread and the drinking the wine when you go for mass. No. Do this in remembrance for me means what? My whole life, my miracles, my sacrifice, and whatever passion I am going through, why I was nailed on the cross. This you have to go and tell the world. Not only give them bread and wine. No. That is your human thinking. So be careful what you are reading, what you are hearing, what preachers are telling you. This is the job of the preacher. But nobody will tell you like this. I promise you. People will say only build your faith and you will go to heaven. Enough. Be like this. You will be good Christian. That is the end. But I tell you, if you do this, you will go to hell. Listen. Again and again, I'm repeating the same, because we are like kids. We are just coming into the new, the correct, the truth in the Bible. So if you go to see, we are like babies. We are just drinking the milk now, like babies. For 1 year, 6 months, they are given only light food, drink milk or light something, juice or something, but light. So why I'm focusing every day on the same topic, the same words are coming, mostly many days same words are coming. I'm putting them here and there, and I want to make it clear to you. Running and finishing the Bible, we finish the Bible study useless. I know people who have finished, have the diploma and the certificates of Bible study, professional Bible study. 1 week, 1 month, 6 months, there are Bible courses are there. And if you finish that, you get a certificate or a diploma. As per the long the course, you get a diploma, bigger the course. If you do 1 week or 1 month, you get a certificate. People are having everything, but what is the use? They will die fast. 60, 70, finish. Where is the certificate? What is the use? God has promised new life, long life, abundant life, plans to prosper you. Even there's a scripture for the old age. Old age means what? 100 we can calculate like old age. These people 60, 70, that is not old age. That is people are dying early because they are not in the word. Mark my point. Old age is 100 minimum. We have to go 110, 120. We have to touch as per the God. Long life. But old age, if we consider, at least we can minimum say when we are getting a little bit old, we can say 100 you can catch. But there is a scripture in the Bible clearly saying, if you type on the Google, you will get, in the old age, you will be green. Green means what? Hairs will not become white? No, not like that. Green means what? You will be fresh. Like you see green plants, fresh, not becoming leaves yellow. People will think, no, his age is now 40. No, he must change his color of the dress. At 40, you must wear green or brown, not red and yellow. That is for the girls, pink, and this is for small kids, girls, and until you are 20 or 25. Once you get married, your color must change of the dress. It must become brown or green, a coffee, a blue, purple, like this, no, sad colors, because they are growing older. That is the mind of the people. People will try to put, devil is doing this. He will tell you this, you are getting old, finish. On 60 you die, 70 you die. But Bible is saying, even at the old age you are green. Green means fresh. Wear any color. Put red, yellow, white, green, yellow, red. Put any pink, orange. Put any color. You want it 100, no problem. So this is our thinking. Bible is saying, you will be green. And second, Bible is saying, You will be full of sap. Sap means what? We are saying, I am 40, I am 50, I am getting retired. Now my legs are paining, my body is aching, my back is giving me trouble. I got arthritis. I have this. All these people are thinking in their mind. Now I'm getting retired. So these things will happen to me also. Because doctor asked me for last appointment. My sugar was a little bit high. Doctor was asking me, your any relation have your parents, father, mother have diabetic? Like this, where doctors are putting fear in the people. If they had diabetic, your sugar is a little more, I will give you a tablet for diabetic. See? Then cholesterol, doctor is saying every year you have to check. Cholesterol is a little more. Did anybody die of a heart attack? Your grandfather? Then you say, yes. Oh, heart attack, yeah, then risk for you. Some tablets for cholesterol. So doctor is going to putting problems and medicines and so much complication. And then say pressure. Anybody had pressure? You have pressure. So you cannot eat sugar. You cannot eat sweet. Now you cannot do anything now. And nowadays people are saying only at 30 they die of heart attack. Or 40 people are dying of heart attack. This is the news going on. People are getting afraid. The fear is building up. And doctors are putting pressure. Come for checkup. Once you are 30, come every year. Once you are 40, come 6 months. Once you are 50, come every 3 months. Blood test, this test, that test. So this is our world is telling us. But Bible is saying we are full of sap. S-A-P, sap. We will continue this tomorrow. We will leave it here. I will make a point to take the remaining part. We will go into prayers. Everything is equally important because we must also know how to pray. If we only learn, and we do not pray on anybody, then it is a waste. No need to do this Bible class. We must learn, pray, two in one, together, like one, both sides of the coin. One side cannot say, No, I don't want to be there. They have to be there. So learning and praying is very important. So we will pray now. We will close. Amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In Jesus' name I pray.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Keep us free.
Keep us free.
From COVID-19.
From COVID-19.
Bless us with good health.
Bless us with good health.
Full of power.
Full of power.
Full of green.
Full of green.
Bearing fruits.
Bearing fruits.
And make us always victorious.
And make us always victorious.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Please bless Elita and Jesse.
Please bless Elita and Jesse.
With a very good job.
With a very good job.
High salary. Near to their house. Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Bless the business of Alex.
Bless the business of Alex.
Make him victorious. And a big businessman. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Euphemia.
Bless
your
family.
Leah.
Leah.
And Aruna. With all good things. Good blessings.
Blessings.
And keep them free from COVID-19.
And keep them free from COVID-19.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray. Bless Alex and Jamily.
Bless Alex and Jamily.
And their daughter Lorraine.
And their daughter Lorraine.
With peace of mind.
And peace of mind.
Love.
Love.
Unity.
Unity.
Cooperation.
Cooperation.
So that they live together.
They live together
as a joyful family.
As a joyful family.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Mackley and his family. With good health.
With good health.
And your truth. And keep them free from COVID-19.
And keep them free from COVID-19.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless William and Connie.
Bless William and Connie.
With all good things.
With all good things.
And destroy.
Their unbelief.
Fear.
Bondages.
And give them your truth.
Amen.
Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Bless Zina.
Bless Zina.
And Alfio. With lot of children. Amen.
Heavenly Father.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Bless the job of Andrew.
Give him promotion. Increase his salary. And give him 40 hours per week.
Amen.
Heavenly Father. Touch the tongue of Jaden. Free his speech.
Free his speech.
Make him a teacher.
Make him a teacher.
Bless him. And bless his parents.
And bless his parents.
Keep them free from COVID-19. Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Whoever listens to this preaching.
Whoever listens to this preaching.
Touch their mind.
Touch their mind.
Pass my anointing. Pass my faith.
Pass my faith.
To them. And make them holy.
And make them holy.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Heavenly Father. Please bless the family of Navita.
Please bless the family of Navita.
Keep them in good health.
Keep them in good health.
Destroy all the sicknesses.
Destroy all the sicknesses.
And bless their jobs.
And bless their jobs.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.